Office 365 and Exchange Server user photos can be displayed in Outlook, OAuth, SharePoint, and Skype, and other Microsoft tools connected to these platforms. But you probably knew this already. What you probably didn't know is that you can also add Office 365 and Exchange user photos to email signatures in your organization, making your company emails more attractive and letting coworkers put a colleague's face on day-to-day interactions. So, how do you actually get this to work? Well, first you have to upload employees' photos to Active Directory or Office 365. You can do this using PowerShell or one of our freeware tools, CodeTwo Active Directory Photos or CodeTwo User Photos for Office 365. Now, to insert the correct photo into each of the thousands of emails traveling through your servers every minute, you need to use a specialized email signature management application. CodeTwo Exchange Rules and CodeTwo Email Signatures for Office 365 are perfect for the job. Both programs let you manage email signatures based on an intuitive rule system. Every email signature rule you create consists of a set of criteria and an email signature template, which is added to an email if it meets the criteria. When it comes to adding user photos to emails, the template is the most interesting part. It lets you use various dynamic fields, which are updated with corresponding information like users' Active Directory data when emails travel through your server. One of the variables is the photo placeholder. I'm going to quickly show you how to use it. I've already prepared an email signature rule for internal email and can start designing the email signature template. To start the email signature template editor, I'm going to click Edit. Now, I'm going to create a very simple email signature template for intro organizational purposes. As you can see, the signature will be inserted beneath the message in email conversations. I'm going to need a two-cell table. There we go. In the right cell, I'm going to put the most important user details, first and last name, title, department, and phone number. In the left cell, I'm going to add the photo. The placeholder is in the message sender category. There it is. Keep original dimensions and OK. Adjust the width of the cell, and that's it. Click Save and close the editor. As I mentioned earlier, all of the placeholders I used in the template will be turned into users' data when the message travels through the server. So, for instance, if I send an email to one of my colleagues, when they receive it, the email signature should contain my photo, name, and so on. Okay, let's try it out. I'm going to compose a new email. Subject, just a test. Just sending my new email signature. And send. I didn't have to add a signature because the CodeTwo application is going to insert it on the server level. Here it is. And as you can see, all placeholders have been updated. And the left cell contains my photo. To learn more about adding users' photos to email signatures on Exchange and Office 365, follow these links. Thanks for watching.